I'll put it to you like this. Tyler's definitely a superstar. He's just one of those kids that like draws the attention.
When the lights dim and the music gets loud, the stress, the problems, the struggle, everything it took to get to this moment, once I hit that stage, I feel like I finally come alive. Music really changed my life, you know? This is what I want to do for the rest of my life, and I'm not going to stop until I get it. I've been on my own since I was like 15, running the streets, being wild, sleeping couch to couch, doing things I wasn't supposed to do. And I felt like that moment was just to move to LA to get away from all that and really achieve this dream. So me and my friends, we just packed a car up and drove all the way from Orlando. First time I drove it, but the next time I own it, yeah. Live by the moment, I know that's how I want it. I got one life to live. I wanna live in the city of dreams. I had probably a couple $1,000s to my name. Didn't know where I was gonna go. And we had an Airbnb for like a month. And once that month went down, my boy's like, yo, we gotta fly back to Florida. We're not staying out here, you know? I told him to drop me off on Venice. And all I had was a skateboard and a suitcase. And that whole journey of being homeless and sleeping in alleys, sleeping in cars, sleeping on Venice Beach itself, it just gave me that fuel to keep going and really wanted to achieve this dream.
I was on my Explore page. You know, just random shit just be popping up. It's like Tyler Yahweh performing at Rolling Loud. Like 60 people or 100 people somewhere around there. Just wilding the fuck out, holding the kid's head down, throwing weed in the crowd. And just like that, I don't give a fuck energy. I was just following him. He was like having subliminal messages out there because I think he was, you know, chasing his shit and frustrated at where he was at with it and how he was doing it by himself. So, you know, I DM'd him, we tapped in. Got him in the studio. We just started working on some shit and just kind of like naturally building a friendship and relationship.
Move on to find yourself. It's time to let it go.
I found everything.
Damn, look at that show.
Move on to find yourself. It's time to let it go.
Being on a world tour with Post Malone, one of the biggest artists in the world, changed my life, you know, changed my perception on how many different cultures I got to see, how many different fans I got to touch. Being on the road has been the best time of my life. Like, all the moments of just turn up, being on different planes, being on a tour bus. I never thought I was ever gonna have my own tour bus. Traveling back to back, doing radio interviews. The stage is just it's my meditation. Like, I let go and feel like I just drift into colors of energies and different frequencies and feeling everybody's vibes of rage and just people crying and laughing, screaming and just having a good time. That's what keeps me going. And I love being on the road. I can do this forever.
I'm so done with the chain, done with the bullshit.
What motivate me the most. It's amazing to see people sing every word for word and know your life and know where you're gonna be. Like, they're outside of your hotel waiting for you with like records and pictures. And I love my fans, and I don't even like calling them fans. I like calling them my family, my Ragers, you know?
We're all kind of like the misfit crew, the misfit kids that people overlooked that made it anyway.
I don't know about nothing. I don't care about nothing.
Feel better?
Absolutely nothing.
Mr. Yahweh, nigga.
He's probably one of the most energetic people I know.
He's crazy and full of energy.
You know, one of the kids is just bouncing off the walls all the time.
Jay, I'm kidding.
It's a rock star night, sleeping on silk sheets. Said I, not a killer, but don't push me. I be riding in the drop, going full speed. And you never understand what it took me.
The side of Tyler that I think a lot of people don't get to see or don't get to know is that he really does have a very, like, soft, loving side on the other end, you know what I mean? Like, he really does care for the people around him, and he wants to see everybody win.
But I love y'all. I got the best team in the world. Y'all always got my back. Y'all always there for me. I love y'all to death. Rager Boys to death, y'all.
Rager Boys.
It's really important to have a team that's going to be there for you through your ups and downs, that's going to pick you up when you need some more fuel in the tank. They're there for you, you know, at all times. Luckily, I had my mom, you know, like, my mom was really there, like, yo, you got this, son. Like, no one else in our family has got this opportunity, and you did it, you know. This is God's plan.
Oh, shit! My mom on TV!
He's the rock star, but then he's also the person at the end of the day who's trying to promote, you know, a good message.
I love you too. Way, and I've just used all that energy and channeled all that into this new music, and I found myself. Healing.
Stick your silhouette on top my ceiling. I wanna stay stuck inside this feeling.
It's been like 4 years since I release a body of work. It felt like 10 years to me because the process was just so long. Like, made an album, scrapped it, made another album, scrapped it. We went through like 3-4 albums and scrapped them to get this body of work. I was really just searching for myself, or I was searching for my sound, I was searching for who I was. And to be honest, these last 4 years, it was a struggle, you know. I went through some dark phases, you know, not knowing if I wanted to make music ever again, not knowing if, like, my career was gonna keep going. Sometimes I felt like I was shelved, you know?
I think the best thing that you can do, and the best indicator that you're doing something right, is to have people who look down on you, who hate on what you're doing. I mean, that tells you that you're in the right direction. And I think that this is one of those albums that, respectively, is gonna make those people circle the block. And I think that that's why we go so hard for this. That's why he goes so hard for this. And I'm really excited to watch that happen for him, because it'll be an I Told You So.
A lot of this music is here today and gone tomorrow. And I don't want to make music like that. This album right here, I wanted to create a legacy for myself. And I really just want to show people that there's more music that can inspire you to be something, anything that you want to be, and move on. Like, we need music, you know? We listen to music every single day. So I'm tapping into an energy to give y'all something that y'all never heard before.
Tyler is so versatile. He can do country, he can do pop, he can do hip hop, he can do R&B. And I think that just being able to create music that people would look at you and not expect is honestly, like, the place to be.
I'm so excited to express myself in new waves and new energies and just a new Tyler Yahweh that y'all get to experience and y'all get to see grow right in front of your eyes.
New album's coming soon.
I just want to give a shout out to everybody that's on this album. Shout out to Chris Brown, shout out to Ty Dolla Sign, Dej Loaf, Young Blue, Tusi. The best artist that's popping right now, too, at that. It's just amazing to have them part of this whole record. And I love them for that. Thank you.
Sideways when I feel stuck. We can't get too gonna dance. Wake up and yearn and pour it.
This song, Stuck, featuring Ty Dolla Sign, this is actually one of the last songs that we got on there, too. Like, we was like, let's just keep working. And I was going through so much at that moment. I was in a relationship, going back and forth, breaking up, making up, breaking up, making up. I had to, like, put all that emotion into that song. Like, I had to get it out. It was just this is what I was feeling, this is how I was feeling, and it's what I was going through. And I wanted to show my fans that. And I feel like it's a very vulnerable part of me that I love to show y'all. And then all I can think about is like, yo, Ty Dolla $ign would be amazing on this song. Like, he definitely brings out that soul. This song is my favorite song, and it was the last song that we got to put on the record. And I feel like that's the one that's like finishing the last pieces of the puzzle.
Hey, bitch. New GT in the back, I got them curtains. Don't go pretending this ain't living, don't be nervous.
City of Dreams is the second single on this album, and I got my brother Chris Brown on this record. He blessed me, he really blessed me. Like, one day he calls me to come over to the crib, and then we played City of Dreams, and he was like, why haven't you sent me this song? Recorded the song literally in 15 minutes, and we made this banger, you know? This is a undeniable banger, and it's gonna be a club banger. It's gonna be all over the radio, and hopefully we go number one with this.
We making mansion music right now. We making real mansion music right now. We making bullshit records. We making mansion music.
Lighters up. Down bad, not partying with my idols. No fear, so I try to take the high road. But we gon' set this bitch up on arrival.
Lighters up. We recorded this record in Joshua Tree. Just enjoying the music and really locking in with the music. And I'm listening to it over and over again, and Dej Loaf's name just pops in my brain. So I hit her up, I'm like, I got a song. She's like, yo, send it to me ASAP. I sent it to her, and I got it back the next day. She was one of those artists that had a sound that no one can replicate, and she started a lot of people's waves, you know? I had to get her on the song.
Love is the type of shit that get you killed for nothing. No, 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 no. Got my head up high, one hand on my body.
She blessed us with an amazing, amazing verse that I get knowledge from, you know?
Touchdown in another place. It's a Saturday, turn my locations off. Background and I never change. I just went away and I live with it all day. I'm lonely.
You know, I just feel like we, you know, got this new sound that I feel is like his most complete sound. I feel like it's him all the way, and you know, he's unapologetically himself now. So, and I love it. I'm here for it, and I just want to see it, you know, see it out. And I just feel like we're finally at that point.
Low key, I think it's endless for him. I think like he's one of those dope human beings that you can't really box in any space and stuff like that. And I, you know, like his inspirations, you know, what he's chasing is bigger than just one genre. You know, it's like a kid that just really passionately wants to get his energy to the world. He wants to be able to put his art out there, put his stamp out there. Kid trying to create a legacy, you get what I'm saying? And never being like, never stopping, bro. Like, you get what I'm saying? I think a lot of people on this journey with some, like, this shit'll fuck up your mental sometimes.
I think one word that I can use to describe Tyler Yahweh right now is resilience, you know? He's had to overcome a lot of obstacles to stand here and to be here. He's gonna have to overcome a lot more obstacles to stand where he wants to be.
I just did a lot of soul searching within myself, like tap into who I am as a person. Learning how to find myself and learning how to be myself and learning who I was gonna be in the next 30, 40 years. So I just honed in and just took all that, took all those emotions and put it into this music. Why aren't we giving people the real, like, real good music that's gonna pick people up and give them something that's brand new, that's fresh, and it's like, that's gonna live forever. These 4 years of making Heartful of Rage 2 was definitely worth it, you know, and it's gonna be worth it for the people. It's gonna be worth it for y'all ears. I am out of my head.